At midnight tonight, Channel 8 will turn off its analog signal. Here's what that means for you come tomorrow.
Are you ready for digital television? Well, ready or not, here it comes. June 12th is the deadline for most stations to turn off their analog signals, leaving only their digital broadcasts. But here at 8, we're shutting down analog transmission at midnight, Wednesday, April 29th.
We're pioneers, yes.
And like all pioneers, we're heading into some uncharted territory.
8 will be shutting off our analog channel and changing digital frequencies from UHF 29 to VHF 8.
8's been airing spots like these to help viewers in the Phoenix area prepare for digital TV. Viewers of cable or satellite television shouldn't be affected at all.
It's the people who are watching over an antenna. Well, if they haven't done the preparation, we've been telling people for a long time what they need to do. If they haven't prepared, I can kind of simulate what they'll see. They will see something like that.
Your analog television may look like this until you connect it to your antenna through an analog-to-digital converter box. But even if you already have a converter box or a brand new digital television, there's more you need to know.
When we change frequencies on Thursday morning, some sets, in fact most sets, will probably lose the ability to receive us. They'll kind of lose their memory. And at that point, viewers will have to rescan their sets, do a channel scan, auto search, whatever it's called on your set.
It's important to periodically rescan your digital TV or converter box to ensure you're getting all the channels available to you.
So you should be familiar with how to do that right now so that come Thursday morning, you don't have to be without Channel 8.
Channel 8 viewers living outside Maricopa and Pinal counties will continue receiving analog television as they always have. However, in areas near Prescott, Globe, Williams, and Sholo, viewers will lose Channel 8, but only temporarily.
People in the outskirts that watch us on translators, they will be off the air for a day or two, we hope, no more than that, some of the areas. But we have to go up there and change out some equipment at those translators. But within a day or two, we should be back on the air on those analog translators. And those people won't have to do anything either. They'll still continue watching the translators over the antenna just as they are now.
Make sure you're prepared for digital TV by visiting our website at azpbs.org/digital.
Here now to tell us if Arizona is ready for digital television is Art Brooks, president and CEO of the Arizona Broadcasters Association. Good to see you. Are we ready
for
this?
Yeah. We're ready.
We're ready, huh?
We were ready February 17th.
What happened? How come it didn't happen February 17th?
NTIA, which is the governing agency in Washington that oversees the coupon program, ran out of funding at the first of the year. And so they just received a major gift from the stimulus package of $650 million to boot it back up again.
All right. Let's reiterate again. Let's try to make it as clear as we can after we've already tried to make it as clear as we can. You receive over-the-air signal. You need a converter box. If you got rabbit ears or an antenna on the roof and that's all you got, you'll need a converter box.
Or a new TV set.
Or a new
You can have a new TV set and be over the air and be just fine, but the converter box is what you need.
How much do the converter boxes cost?
From 40 to 80 bucks or so.
And where do you get them?
Any retail store, Walmart, Best Buy, Circuit City, or Circuit City's gone now, but Radio Shacks, any place where you can buy electronics.
How much of a migraine is it to hook these converter boxes up?
It's simple. On the back of the box, there's an antenna in. So whatever you're using for an antenna, rabbit ears or rooftop, goes into that little slot, and then it says out to TV. So it's really that simple.
So simple a caveman could do it.
I don't know if you and I could.
Yeah. So again, if you have a new television, really new, the new television that are digitally?
In my office, I have a 42-inch Samsung high-def TV up to an antenna. Beautiful. Beautiful digital high-def pictures.
You're fine.
Fine.
Okay. Cable. You're fine.
Fine.
Satellite. You're fine.
Done.
Okay. Are you really fine, or do you need to rescan? Will those of us with cable need to rescan?
After June 12th, and tonight at midnight, I would suggest rescanning to make sure you're still receiving 8 on 8. Because what happens is a lot of the digital channels that stations were assigned are not there over-the-air channel.
Real quickly, what does rescanning mean?
It means that your TV will automatically seek out and find those channels correctly.
So, real quick, again, why is this being done?
Well, it started in 96, but you don't want to go back that far.
No, not that far.
But to remain relevant, technically, TV had to do this. They had to go digital from analog because it's such a better picture than ever, and they can do more with it. You get more channels, more bang for the buck.
Okay, we're making this switch at midnight.
Right.
Other stations, not necessarily so.
No, everybody else will be June 12th.
Okay, last question. We have about 30 seconds.
Okay.
Which question have you heard the most?
Do I need a new antenna? And the answer to that question is hook up your present antenna first, and then if you have some antenna problems, go to dtvanswers.com. You can put in your area code or your zip code, and it'll tell you what antenna is best for you.
All right. I hope we made it simple. I mean, it's just been going on, and people have so many questions. Thank you for coming on.
And enjoy Channel 8. They have four or three additional channels.
That's right.
Yeah.
We do, yeah. Right. So there's more of 8 to go around. Good to see you. Thanks for joining us.
Good to see you, Ted.